Yeah, okay. Let's see if I can pick up the Sculptor Galaxy. Center Sculptor.
To telescope slew into target.
Yeah, I'm doing a meridian flip now.
Telescope slew complete.
Okay. Let me see. Oh, I'm still live stacking. Turn that off.
Okay. Turn off the blue lights.
Okay, let's get that centered. And now we did a meridian flip, so east and west are reversed, so now I have to go... Oh, and you got NGC 288, the globules at the very top. There's a nice globula right near 253. That a lot of people overlook. Okay, we're centered on the Sculptor Galaxy.
Telescope synced.
Okay. Turn that off. Raise the black point to about 110 or 20. 125. Looks like a satellite passing right above the globular. Yep, sure enough. Actually, the globular is below. Lower in the sky than the Sculptor Galaxy. I just had the image flipped. So let's do some live stacking now that the satellite's gotten out of the field of view. That's too bad, Rusty. I guess eventually everybody will be able to get Elon Musk's system if they want it. Maybe I'll just put a little designation in. NGC 288. And of course this is NGC 253. I'm gonna put a long sleeve tee on. It's getting a little cool out here. see what's going on with the wife. Okay, her sugar's going up. Okay. God, is there mosquitoes in here? Sheesh. This galaxy is 7-9. There's another edge on galaxy right above it, NGC 247. It's about 2 magnitudes fainter. So let's go to it, SLU to and center.
Telescope SLU into target. Telescope SLU complete.
There it is right in the center. It's much fainter. Put the properties up on the screen. So it's NGC 247. Much fainter surface brightness than the Sculptor galaxy. How small the skull's gonna look in this thing. The skull is right above this target, NGC 246. After this, I'm gonna move, I think, further north. Heart Nebula and okay. So we got a few in the stack, but this is not much fainter. Find this the skull.
Telescope SLU into target. Telescope SLU complete.
Change the exposure, see if I can go to a longer exposure down here. I'm going to try 15 seconds. Because I am in the light pollution down there. But there's a little galaxy to the lower right. Maybe too much. Let me see. I'll lower the black and see if that controls it. Live stacking. Okay. NGC 246, the skull. NGC 246, the skull, and below it is this little faint fuzz. Is NGC 255. How far away is it? They don't give the distance. Face on. Anything else in the field of view? Let's see. Let me crank the magnitude up on the chart. Show another galaxy, but I'm not seeing it. Now we're getting deep. That little fuzz right below the star MCG galaxy at magnitude 15.5. Point 7 giga years from Earth. That's 700 million light years. Interesting. And the skull didn't come out bad after all. Okay. Anybody new come in? Nope, still the same. Let's go further. Let's go to the heart.
Telescope slew into target.
Let's see where we end up with this. Well, we've got to rotate the dome.
Telescope slew complete.
The blue you see is the blue LEDs reflecting off the dome as the dome rotates. Okay. Oh, and I forgot to change that I was at 15 seconds. Son of a gun. Okay, there's the heart. So let me go to a longer exposure and then we'll see what happens. Let's go to 20 seconds. I'm going to apply a 20 second dark. Enable it. All right, I already see the fish head. Am I still live? Hopefully. Saturation's now at 80. exposure is now at 20 seconds. And let's start live stacking. Okay, Steve. See what happens when I stack. Again, tonight I'm not using a filter at all. So now we've got two in, one out, so they're starting to average. Try a little bit longer exposure. I know Jeff with this camera likes going to about 80 gain, 80 out of 100. I'm at 50 out of 100.
Telescope synced.
And after this, I'll go over to the Sol Nebula, see if I can get it in there. I'm also going to try, let's see, let me go to longer exposure, see if I can do it. Stop. Go to 25. Add it to the loop. Shows I kind of started at 20 and then I added a 25. Let's see what happens. It definitely shifted the curve to the histogram shifted to the left, I mean to the right. Smoke in the air. It's burning a trash pile started yesterday with some pine shavings, and they've been smoldering for the last 24 hours. And it's drifting right over the observatory. doesn't look bad at all. I'm going to quickly switch over to the sole.
Telescope slew into target.
It's not that far.
Telescope slew complete.
Simon, I started at 0.2 earlier. Then I went to 0.4, then I went to 1. Right now I'm at 1.3. I've been trying different settings. Satellite. Let me lower the red a little bit. Be too long of an exposure. Let me stop and go down to 20 seconds. Simon, do you normally use filters when you observe, correct? Because I have no filter tonight. And I'm using my 61 millimeter refractor tonight at about 5.9 times 0.8. About F46, 47. Yeah, I didn't use a filter. I had been using filters the last few nights. Ellen Hans, I had tried the Optolong H Alpha last week. Tonight I decided to try it without filters. I know Rock says that's a no-no, but in fact he was on earlier. The filter to this one, I would have to disassemble part of the focal reducer field flattener. It's actually a two-piece unit. You can separate the two parts, add the filter internally, and then put them back together. The other night I tried going for the California Nebula, but I ended up catching the telephone pole, I mean the power line. Try the California Nebula next. Okay, I'll stop the live stack. Let me center on the California. Center.
Telescope slew into target.
Okay, let me get the dome out of the way.
Telescope slew complete.
Okay, let's see if we got the power line.
Lights off. And there she be. Start live stacking. And the Pleiades is up already. Rock recommends saving the darks at whatever setting you're going to be using for the other parameters. Where is Andromeda? Cassiopeia, Riga. Triangulum, oh, I see, okay. I'm at playing around with my small scope tonight. Testing out that new field flattener focal reducer from William Optics. It appears to work a lot better. I got a slightly smaller field of view, but I don't have nearly the amount of coma at the corners. Very slight bit, but not bad at all. I didn't run one of the images through astrometry yet. I'll do that tomorrow morning to get the true field of view. With the Ritchie accretion focal reducer, I was getting about a 5.8 degree field. And this focal reducer has a little bit less focal reduction, so I should probably get about a 5.4 degree field. Still plenty big enough. Let's go to the double cluster, just for the heck of it. Stop the live stack.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
The next refresh. Probably don't need 20 seconds for this. Wow, it was a there's enough stars to stack on. I'm gonna cut the exposure down to 15 seconds. That was a pretty impressive Andromeda you got with your 8-inch Raza. Eight tenths of a second. very nice. Yeah, I did notice, Simon, that when going to the lower gamma, I could go at a shorter exposure. Like you said, you do get a little bit more noise, and it does average out as you average stack. I was just playing. Yeah, I did the 0.2, then I went, like I said, 0.4, then I went to 1. Now I'm at 1.3, so trying different things. Let's go to Andromeda.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
Night outside. Got the dome out of the way and the blue lights are now off. Let's see what happens. Yeah, 15 seconds. Okay. And now let me start the average stacking. Okay, so you start with one and then drop it down. Okay. But that's using the Allen Hands filter. Oh, anyway, okay. Yeah, Matt, that looked good last night. Like I said, this is a 15-second exposure. The gain is at 50 out of 100, so half gain. Gamma's 1.3. Contrast, I think, is still set at 0. Contrast 0, gamma 1.3, saturation reduced to 80. And right now I'm live stacking. It looks pretty good. Let me zoom to 100%. Make it 75. Okay. What's the number on that star cluster out at the end of Andromeda? NGC 206. Okay, I can try that afterwards. So this is NGC 206, which is right there, a little cloud in the So this is at gamma 1.3. It looks quite nice. Let's do an experiment now. So let's stop this. Go to gamma min. Okay, and now let's shift see what happens when we shift the uh, 15 seconds, maybe too much. Let's see. No. Okay, so now we're at a little bit more detail in the outer arms. Let me start live stacking. Okay. So this is gamma 0.2. Core of the galaxy is much brighter and blown out. Yes, it is. Let me go back to 75% zoom. And M110 is a little bit larger. You see more extended glow around the core. Yeah, this is amazing for a 2.4-inch refractor. Yeah, there's a lot more more detail, like up in here. That you, I didn't see before. Spinning too. Hey, you can see that one arm. How you doing, Lance? Yeah, that one dark lane appears to come here and loop back around. There's a dark lane out here, looping around. Might be the extension of this one. Yeah, a little galaxy, M110 really looks nice. It's 150 times zoom now. It's not bad at all. Sling Wing. Hi, Bernie. Hi, Bernie. Jules. See who else has popped in. Well, after this, I'm going to go to Triangulum. It's an 85.9, but I have the William Optics 0.8 field flattener focal reducer in, so where's my calculator? Clear, 5.9 times 0.8, so I'm at f4.7 right now. With my big 2.4 inch refractor. So let's go over to the Pinwheel Galaxy and
telescope slewing to target.
And make sure it's still in the shutter opening.
Telescope slew complete.
Yes, it is. Okay. Turn the blue lights off. There it is, right in the center.
Another white balance. See if it changes. 24.49. Let's see. 24.48. Slight change. Okay. Now let's start the average stacking. Yeah, Bernie, with the 0.75 RC focal reducer, I was getting 5.82 degrees. I'm guessing I'm around 5.4 degrees. I'll run an image through astrometry tomorrow and get the field of view it calculates. The advantage of the field flattener focal reducer is it gives much less coma at the edges of the field. There's a very slight bit, whereas it was very annoying the other night with the rich accretion focal reducer in. Yeah, Jeff is he's been getting it while he can, because he says shortly with the winter weather up there, he'll be fogged out and snowed out. They won't be able to do anything for months. I know here it's very humid. When I drove the golf cart back to the house before to check on the wife, the seat was dripping wet, and that was about an hour ago. So I don't know what the humidity is tonight, but it's pretty darn high. I know Rock was getting his tractor front end loader ready so he can shovel the snow so he can clear a path out to his observatory when the snow starts falling. That we don't have to worry about here. No, not really, Vernie. It is a field flattener, along with the 0.8 focal reduction. Yeah, Rock just had his serviced at the dealer to get it ready. He's got a heated cab. He can get in there and shovel the driveway and all out. Yeah, this is 100% zoom. Let me try a little bit higher. There's 150. No, no filters, Jules. Yes. The very top, I have all of the parameters listed. It's a William Optics Zenithstar 61. I've got the William Optics Field Flattener Focal Reducer and the DS26cTEC. The winter broom. Well, that's only because you're down in Tucson instead of up north. But there's the full field right there. Feels looking pretty good. Let me go 20 of these. I'm going to center the Pleiades and see if I can. It's about 37 degrees up right now, so let's go SLU to and center.
Telescope SLU into target.
I'm going to have to rotate the dome. Oh. Yep, due east.
Telescope SLU complete.
Centered, the blue lights are off. And bingo, the power line nebula. Now the question is, which way is it moving relative to the power line nebula? Do another white balance since I'm in a different area of the sky. 2448. Let's see what happens. Very similar. So if I do a live stack, it's going to stack that power line. You can see the stars through the power line. Dan's on now. Hi. Evening, Dan. Oh, it's moving away from the power line. Good. I guess the line is a fairly small and the scope aperture is, I guess, being able to, the part of the lens catches the stars. So let me zoom in to 100%. That's not a post. That's the electric line that runs from the southeast corner of my property to behind my house. That services my house and the neighbor's house with electric power. It's a wire. Yeah. That's why you're able to see the stars. It's fairly narrow in the field of view. Occasionally, I do get the post nebula when I aim to the southeast. I'll get it in the field of view. You're starting to see the browns in the dust. Dark blue around the star, and up at the top you got the brownish reds. See, the higher these is lower, so that will be in, that'll be on the other side of the power line. What if I go up to where's Orion? Orion's belt is on the horizon. Not yet. There it is. What I wanted. How low is Auriga? Let's see. Those might be too low.
Telescope slew into target.
Oh, let's try the flaming star.
Telescope slew complete.
The white is the dome. I just rolled it out of the view. There's the power line at the bottom. The flaming star is supposed to be in the center. Oh. Flaming star doesn't look that great in this wide field of view. Let me try some live stacking, see if it helps. There is some nebulosity around at those bright stars in the center, but it doesn't really stand out. Up at the top, isn't it? Okay, let's see what else we got. Crevice too low, Pleiades. We looked at Pleiades already. See one flaming star now.
that. No, that's too late.
Oh, glad you could stop by, Simon. I won't be up very much longer. I got up real early this morning. You can see how that power line blurred on the lower left. All right, Matt, glad you could stop by. Let's even go to the higher D's. It should be high enough now.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
Finished my coffee. Ah. And it's cold. This image of the Hyades.
Operation completed.
Nope, that's too small. Okay. Let's see, I did a meridian flip. Hopefully this moves it in the right direction. Yep, I think it did. Yeah, I think that's the Hyades now. Bright star is going to be, oh, that's a gamma tauri, 3.7 magnitude. Okay. Stack, see what it's going to look like. Meanwhile, I'm going to